Tonight, the growing anger over the Olympic traffic lanes. When the first of them became active yesterday, it caused confusion. Today, that confusion turned to fury as 200 black cab drivers brought Westminster to a standstill in a protest over the Olympic lane rules. During the Games, even black cabs won't be allowed to use them, which cabbies claim will stop them doing their job. Marcus Powell has our report.
Making their voices heard has never really been a problem for cabbies, but now they're noisier than ever as the Olympics looms, bringing central London to a standstill today, complaining that one minute they used to promote the Games, now they're banned from the Olympic transport lanes. They can't drive in most, stop, drop off or pick up fares. This will double the cost and the time of journeys, according to the drivers.
Lots of very angry cabbies. We all wanted the Olympics to be a success, but we've been shut out from the start. We're ambassadors to this city, and we're the first people that meet and greet tourists when they get here. How are we supposed to do our job? We can't cross the lanes, we can't turn around on Park Lane. Mayfair's like a war zone. It's all shut off when the lanes come into effect. It's just absurd.
We want to do our job. We want to get people to where they want to go at the prices that they expect to pay. We're not asking any rises, as you know. We're just asking to do the job we've been doing all our life.
Hopefully we'll make the mayor see a bit of sense and let us allow us into the Olympic lanes so we can actually drive people where they want to go so that all the Australians don't get lost.
The Olympic organisers want the Olympic lanes reserved for athletes, dignitaries and journalists. But the cabbies argue that buses, cyclists and motorcycles are unaffected, so they want to know why they're the only previous users who are now largely excluded from what were the bus lanes. But the mayor is unmoved.
No, and that's quite right, because they can't use them the whole time. They can't use every bit of them, because you've got a lot of black cabs, 25,000, 26,000 of them, and you put them in the games lanes, you're really nullifying the whole value of the games lane. You'd be destroying. You wouldn't be able to move the athletes around. It'd be a disaster.
Well, the cabbies certainly aren't budging, and nor it seems the Transport for London or the Olympic authorities. Transport for London say that this protest is irresponsible and the cabbies should simply get back to doing what they're supposed to do, which is serve the public. The cabbies argue that they can't do that if they're banned from the Olympic lanes.
More than a million visitors a day are expected in the capital and it should be a boom time in business. But more disruptions on the cards and the cabbies plan further blockades next Monday, then again on Friday, the day of the Olympic opening ceremony. Marcus Powell, London Tonight.